Following this line of thought, like a great detective solving a cryptex, Dracula slowly turned the cylinder of his mind, carefully lining up each letter of his thoughts until the solution had presented itself. As if with a click of alignment, the puzzle began to open to him, and the truth flowed forth, unfurled, like some great and terrible tapestry. And what came next? Chaos! I am lost in something, Alfred. Something greater than myself, than any man. I call it the Wheel of Time. All are powerless to stop its cycle, and I am no different. You say I should, how did you put it, go out and meet a girl? And this is a fine intention, surely. But to do so in a day, I must first wake up. But alas, I wake up more often than not with morning wood. An erection, Alfred, demanding satisfaction. And so, naturally, I service it. I service it for as long as it takes, which, when complete, leaves me spent and hungry. Famished for my self-pleasuring exploits, I do the only natural thing. I eat, and eat, and eat. But now, having eaten, a new feeling descends over me. Lethargy, tiredness, a sense of no purpose. I call it the sludge. Powerless against it, I respond in the only way I am able, by taking a nap. Which, of course, naturally leads me back to waking up. But this time at 9 p.m., far later in the day and well past the window of opportunity to meet said girl. And this is the moment of truth, Alfred. Lying there, having slept all day, too late to go out, yet too early to go back to bed, and here comes the hunger again, like a familiar friend, gnawing at me with a maddening insistence. But it is too late to want to cook anything, so what do I do? You know what I do. I order a pizza and play a game until 4 a.m. and then fall asleep and do the entire thing over again. And so the cycle continues. The Wheel of Time is a cruel, unending spiral, an Ouroboros which, once inside, no man may escape.
Master!
Alfred responded in a tired recognition.
There are but two names for this blight, each as terrible as the other. The first, procrastination, and the second, depression.
The realization slowly wrapped around Dracula's mind, ensnaring it, the truth of Alfred's theorem condemning him to the unavoidable reality of his situation.